Welcome back to Edinburgh, and this is the second of my winter walkabout videos where I'm going to give you some ideas for your visit to Edinburgh in 2023. Hopefully show you some restaurants, some cafes, some bars, some places of interest. Now I'm starting today down here in Holyrood Park. I'm going to have a look round here, then we're going to walk all the way up to the top of the Royal Mile towards the castle and hopefully show you lots of gems between here and there. We're going to start our little walk today here at St Margaret's Loch, and if you like swans, this is definitely the place to come to see them. Those tourists are feeding the swans Doritos. Not sure that's exactly classed as swan food, is it? But then maybe the swans do like the Doritos, who knows? Up there on the clifftop, you can see St Antony's Chapel and well, one of the glorious sights you can see here in Holyrood Park. You don't actually have to travel too far into Holyrood Park to actually convince yourself you're not in Edinburgh at all, but actually in the Highlands of Scotland. It's that easy to lose yourself. Of course, Holyrood Park contains Arthur's Seat, that mountain in the middle of Edinburgh, which you can climb to the very top of. If you're going to climb up Arthur's Seat, you really need to bring some proper walking shoes. It's a bit of a steep climb, whichever direction you go in. If you want to walk all the way around the park, it's 5K. Perfect distance for a beautiful day like today. So that's where we're heading next, right back into Edinburgh. So we've got Calton Hill up there. You can just see the poo emoji in the St James Quarter. And then Prince's Street with the Balmoral Hotel. And further round, which we're going to go to, the castle right on the top of the Royal Mile. Well, we've seen St Margaret's Loch. Here is St Margaret's Well. If you listen very carefully, you can hear the water percolating down through the rocks of Arthur's Seat. Now, if you do the perimeter walk all the way around Holyrood Park, you're eventually going to see these magnificent cliffs, the Salisbury Crags. To climb up to the top, you have to go into the middle of Arthur's Seat and then climb up from the back. But the views from the top are incredible. But once again, don't forget those walking shoes. And nestled just underneath those Salisbury Crags is the dynamic earth. Look at it, it's a sort of mini O2 building from London, isn't it? It's an interactive museum for the entire family. And it goes right back to the creation of the world's volcanoes and everything, through the dinosaurs, the ascent of the current age of man and animals, weather systems, science experiments, you name it, it's in there in dynamic earth. We're getting towards the bottom of the Royal Mile now, and the next thing to see is the Scottish Parliament building. Now, I don't know about you, but I'm not a political animal. In fact, most politicians make me want to stick my foot through the television whenever I hear them open their mouths. But you can't deny the historic significance of the Scottish Parliament. And the building itself is really architecturally ingenious. It is open to the public as well, so you get the chance to go in and explore. Let's just have a quick look at that architecture. And right across the road from the Parliament is the Palace of Holyrood House. So in the space of about 5 minutes walk, you've got Dynamic Earth, the Scottish Parliament, and the Queen's Residence.
Thank you.
Well, I went and said the Queen's residence then, didn't I? Of course, it's now the King's residence. But the Queen's been around for my entire life. It's a very hard habit to break, to say the King instead of the Queen. All right, let's head right up the Royal Mile, which is just there in front of us. And there's an incredible number of restaurants, bars, cafes, hotels, and everything going up the Royal Mile, so I'll do my best to point out as much as I can. More of that interesting Parliament building architecture. As you walk up and down the Royal Mile, you're going to notice these side streets, which are all called closes. They're more like little ginnels or snickets, very narrow, very old school. And it's always worth having a look down these closes because you'll find some of the best restaurants, some of the best bars, some of the best shops, and some of the best museums. Delicious Scottish hog roasts. The Kinderkiln Bar and Coffee House. Another one of the many cafes and bistros here on the Royal Mile, Cafe Vivo. This one is well worth a visit, especially if you like traditional fish and chips. That's Canongate, Kirk. This is one of my favourite buildings on the Royal Mile. It's called the Tollbooth, with its clock inaugurated in 1884. And of course, at the bottom, the Tollbooth Cafe. Tollbooth Tavern, indeed. If you need something more than just a hotel, here is the Adagio Appartatel. So, not just a room, kitchenette as well. Cafe Bistro Luscious. You can even have Eggs Benedict in there. Travel Lodge just off the Royal Mile might be a good place to base yourselves. And of course, we're starting to see some great pubs here. This is the Waverley, and of course, the famous World's End pub. Why is it called the World's End? Well, back in history, Edinburgh used to be a walled city, and the World's End was right on the edge of the walls, and that's where people thought the world ended, hence World's End. Years ago, the company I was working for decided to move me and Mrs. E up to Edinburgh, and we've never left since we got here. And the hotel behind us is the one that we stayed at for the first week after we moved up. It used to be called the Scandic Crown, it's now called the Radisson Blue. It's quite a nice hotel, worth checking out. We stayed right in the top of that turret. We're getting closer to the castle now, and the Royal Mile is pedestrianised from here on in, but it's still got those fantastic cobbles. He doesn't look happy. Adam Smith, didn't he have something to do with economics? Well, I did an economics degree years and years ago. I should know that. St. Giles Cathedral, just off Parliament Square, well worth a look. Behind me, in my opinion, is one of Edinburgh's must-see attractions. It's called Mary King Close. Now, back in ancient times, they actually bricked over part of the city, and Mary King Close is down underneath the part of the city that we're now living in. It's dark, it's dreary, it's haunted, it's fascinating. Get yourself down into Mary King Close and be prepared to be scared. Deacon Brodie's Tavern is another popular Edinburgh pub, another famous Edinburgh pub. Deacon Brodie was a body snatcher who ended up getting hanged for his trouble. Remember what I said about those snickets, those closes? Well, let's go down this one and have a look what we can find. Some of the darkest and gloomiest reveal the best treasure. And down this one, which is called James's Court, you're going to find a pub, which is called the Jolly Judge. Maybe this is the same Jolly Judge that sentenced Deacon Brodie to hang. I love this. Ghostbusters tours. Say it fast. Ghostbusters tours. Ghostbusters. Ghostbusters. What a gorgeous owl. And if you find Boswell's Court, you're going to find one of the poshest restaurants in Edinburgh, the Witchery. Complete with sound effects. Yeah, come to the Witchery if you want to push the boat out. The food is fantastic. And the final few hundred yards of the Royal Mile, past the Scottish Whisky Experience, up towards Edinburgh Castle. And here we are at the top of the Royal Mile, and there is Edinburgh Castle. And what an amazingly gorgeous day it is today. From up here, we've got great views of where we've come from. There you can see Arthur's Seat and those Salisbury Crags. Look how steep they are from here. What an absolutely glorious afternoon it's been here in Edinburgh. I've been so lucky with the weather for my videos this year. I've really enjoyed walking from all the way down the bottom there in Holyrood Park, past Dynamic Earth, past the Parliament, past the Palace of Holyrood, all the way up the Royal Mile, past all those shops, all those cafes, all those hotels and restaurants. Once again, I hope I've given you some good ideas for your visit to Edinburgh in 2023. There's more than just the Royal Mile, of course, so I'll probably pop back in a couple of weeks, if the weather holds up, and do another video with some more ideas for you. Thank you so much for watching this episode of Rog Vlog. Until the next video, remember, there's always something to see. So get out there and find it!